This is Jigoro Kano, the founder of the Kodokan Judo. Professor Jigoro Kano learned the traditional Japanese martial art, Jujutsu, and he transformed it into something new, with an objective and practicing methods appropriate to the new era. In 1882, he named it Kodokan Judo. Judo, which is practiced around the world, is in fact Kodokan Judo. Judo, which Professor Kano promoted with all his might for some 50 years, later became widespread and eagerly pursued in over 150 nations of the world, eventually achieving recognition as an Olympic event. Techniques of judo can be divided into three kinds: nage-waza, katame-waza, and atemi-waza, and there are two ways of practice: dandori and kata. Nage-waza can be divided into tachi-waza and stemi-waza. For each technique, let us now show you the basics and applications, as well as differences between techniques which look alike. Seoi nage. There are two types of seoi nage: morote seoi nage and ippon seoi nage. The hands are used differently when lifting your opponent. This is morote seoi nage. Put your right elbow underneath the side of your opponent's body as you lift him. You grasp one side of your opponent's collar and sleeve. The technique used in throwing him is an application of morote seoi nage. This is ippon seoi nage. You hold and control one of the arms of your opponent as you lift and throw him. Seoi nage with your arm turned. In ippon seoi nage, you sometimes extend one of your legs wide to the outside of your opponent's right leg. Morote seoi nage, executed with a leg extended wide to the outside. This technique is an application of seoi nage and is not taiotoshi. Ippon seoi nage. You throw your opponent by turning him over on top of you. This is ippon seoi nage, executed by grasping your opponent's left arm. The key is to control your opponent's left arm by winding it in under the side of your body. Now let's look at various seoi nage from different contests. Yusuke Yamamoto, the 1987 world champion in the 65 kilogram class. Seoi nage executed by Sumio Endo, a former world champion in the heavyweight class. It's his favorite technique. A beautiful ippon seoi nage executed by Masao Takahashi at a world championships. At the Kano Cup International Tournament, Toshiko Koga shows off his favorite technique, ippon seoi. Seoi otoshi. Seoi Otoshi is a throwing technique where you take your opponent on your back and pull him straight down. As you throw, you can do so either with one knee or both knees on the floor. Seoi Otoshi, moving from an Ippon Seoi Nage position. In Seoi Nage, you throw your opponent by lifting him over, but in Seoi Otoshi, you throw him by pulling him down over you. Seoi Otoshi on both knees. Whether it's Seoi Nage or Seoi Otoshi is decided by whether your opponent was lifted or pulled over. This is Seoi Nage with both knees on the floor. We judge so because after going down on both knees, the throw was made by raising the hip and hoisting the opponent's frame. Seoi Otoshi by Yoshiyuki Matsuoka, the 65kg class champion at the Los Angeles Olympics. Tai Otoshi. There are various ways of executing Tai Otoshi depending on the situation. This is Tai Otoshi executed by drawing the opponent out. This is a tailing Tai Otoshi, executed the moment the opponent moves his leg back. In this Tai Otoshi, the opponent has been drawn out sideways. There are cases where Tai Otoshi is executed by grabbing one side of the collar. Double motion Tai Otoshi. It was executed first of all by lightly kicking the inside of the opponent's foot to make him lose balance. In another instance, you might cross your opponent's arms when executing the throw. By twisting your opponent's arms, his body goes off balance and his resistance is stopped. Hiromitsu Takano, the winner of the Kano Cup, here shows off a spirited Tai Otoshi. At the World Judo Championships in Seoul, Hitoshi Sugai catches Ha Hong Ju of Korea just as they establish their grip, a brilliant Tai Otoshi. Kataguruma. Kataguruma is a technique in which you haul your opponent up above you as you throw. As you can see, the throw is generally made by throwing your opponent down toward the tip of your foot. In kataguruma, the throw can be made in any number of directions after you raise your opponent up. In this case, the opponent is thrown directly in front. It appears that this kind of throw was often used in the early days of modern judo. In this kataguruma, the body of the opponent is raised up high, and the throw is then made by bending backwards. The direction of the throws may differ, but these are all considered kataguruma, and the effect of the throw is recognized. Here you enter low on one knee, raise your opponent up and throw him down. Kataguruma with different forms include this as well. As in Morotegari, you raise your opponent up holding both his legs, then stretching backwards, throw him down. This form is hardly ever seen nowadays, but was apparently one of the techniques in the older schools of Jujutsu. Uki-otoshi. The tori, or active partner, pulls the uke, or passive partner, forward, goes down on one knee, and pulls him down in front. The aim of practicing kata, or form, is to make students realize the principle behind the technique. In uki-otoshi, you sometimes step in the moment your opponent steps forward with his left foot, then execute your throw by pulling him off balance to one side of you. When your right hand is grasping the middle of the sleeve like this, you can force him to go off balance by pushing up on his elbow. Have another look. Dodging your opponent's osotogari by pulling back your leg, turn aside and then throw. This is also uki-otoshi. Sumi-otoshi. Sumi-otoshi is a throwing technique in which you shake your opponent off balance into the rear corner, then throw him by thrusting him down. Using your right hand, you pull up your opponent by grasping his left collar. You make your opponent lose balance by causing him to raise his left foot and shift his weight to his right heel. In another instance, you shift your grip from his left collar to the middle of his sleeve. You then push his elbow up to make him lose balance. Sumi-otoshi and uki-otoshi make up a pair. Let's now look at the difference between sumi-otoshi and uki-otoshi. In sumi-otoshi, you push and throw your opponent down to the rear. In uki-otoshi, you pull and throw your opponent down to the front. The direction of off-balancing and throwing your opponent differs. Sumi-otoshi was one of the favorite techniques of Kyuzo Mifune, the 10th Dan. Pay close attention to the principle of the technique, where you force your opponent's left foot to come forward and throw him down in a backward direction. Sukui Nage. Originally in Sukui Nage, you first pushed your opponent back to make him lose balance, then lifted him up and threw him in a backward direction. This technique is not at all seen in recent tournaments. In a tournament, the technique of placing a hand underneath your opponent's thigh and lifting him up is often used. When your opponent tries a harai-goshi, you should pull your foot back to open yourself up for an attack, then put your hand in from behind your opponent to lift him up and throw him down. Similarly, when your opponent comes at you with an osotogari, then you should again put your hand in from behind and throw. Again, When he attempts an uchimata, you can evade his motion, then putting your hand in from behind, transform it into a sukui-nage. On occasion, you may throw using your hips as you lift your opponent. Another way is to lift your opponent as he tries a hanegoshi, then throw by brushing aside his pivot leg. This time, the opponent is lifted by putting a hand in from the front. When your opponent tries osotogari, pull your foot back, then as you do so, put your hand in from the front and lift him up. The final of the 1976 All Japan Championships. Sumio Endo wins with a sukui-nage. At the Kobe Universiad Competition 65kg Finals, Yun of Korea performs a sukui-nage. Obi Otoshi. Obi Otoshi can be considered a kind of sukui-nage. It is one of the techniques of jiu-jitsu, the traditional martial art. Grasp the front part of your opponent's belt. Push him directly back to cause him to lose balance, lift him from the side, and throw him down towards the rear. The principle of obi otoshi is very much like that of sukui-nage. Obi otoshi is hardly ever used in modern tournaments, but is one of the techniques used in free exercises of Kodokan Judo. Morote-gari. Morote-gari is often used in a competition. There are different ways of starting morote-gari. In this case, you catch your opponent the moment you come to grapple with him. This is morote-gari where you first pull your opponent forward. In this case, seoi-nage turns into a morote-gari. When you attempt seoi-nage, your opponent will react by bending backwards. Morote-gari is then performed without a pause. In following on from a seoi-nage, you sometimes make one complete turn, as you can see here. This also is an application of morote-gari. Here you make your opponent fall by grasping one of his feet using both hands. Morote-gari performed by Kim Jae-yup of Korea, the 1987 world champion in the 60kg class. Kuchiki-daoshi. Kuchiki-daoshi is a technique in which you take your opponent's leg and push him down backwards. It's often used in a tournament. You push your opponent down by taking hold of his leg, but sometimes it's executed from the inside as well as from the outside. In kuchiki-daoshi, you may simply grasp the other's leg, or you may change it into either from your own or your opponent's technique. Here you turn from seoi nage and grasp your opponent's leg from inside. This is a follow-on technique starting from kataguruma. A kataguruma is attempted, but as your opponent defends himself by shifting his weight backwards, the throw is made by grasping his leg from inside. This time we start with the opponent's osotogari. When the opponent attacks with osotogari, defend yourself by opening up, turning sideways. As you do so, catch him from inside his legs to make him fall. Here you down your opponent by catching his leg from outside. When you perform kochigari, your opponent counters by raising the foot that's been swept from the side. Grasp his leg from outside at that moment to make him fall. This time, continuing from ochigari. The moment your opponent raises his foot to counter the move, you catch his leg from outside to drop him. Look closely at the movement of the right hand. This is not seoi nage, but kuchiki daoshi. A continuous movement is made from a seoi nage, and your opponent is made to fall with the right hand on the outside of his leg. Turning your opponent's kizaguruma into this technique. Catching the foot of your opponent as he attempts hizaguruma, push him down with your left hand to make him fall. Kuchiki daoshi, performed by Nagy Szolimos of Hungary at the World Championships. Kibis gaeshi. Kibis gaeshi is a technique in which you fell your opponent by taking hold of his heel. There are two ways of performing kibis gaeshi. Either by grasping the inside of your opponent's heel, or by grasping the outside. First make seoi nage, then turn once to face your opponent to follow on to kibis gaeshi. First, grasping your opponent's heel from outside. Catch your opponent's heel from outside as he tries to withdraw, then cut him down by pushing with your left hand. In the following case too, you grasp the heel from outside. From kochigari, you make your opponent fall by taking the heel of the raised foot from outside. Changing your opponent's izaguruma into this technique. When your opponent attacks with a izaguruma, take his heel from outside to cut him down. Let's compare techniques. In kuchiki daoshi, you push your opponent down by putting your hand on his leg. in kibisgaeshi, you grasp your opponent's heel and cut him right down on the spot. Kouchigaeshi. In Kouchigaeshi, you dodge your opponent's Kouchigari, then drop him by twisting to either right or left. When your opponent attacks with a Kouchigari, you evade by raising the foot that's been struck, then make a throw by twisting him to the left. This time, twisting to the right. Look closely at how you evade the attack and how you make the twist. This is Daiashi Harai, brushing off the starting move. When the Kouchigari of your opponent is brushed off like this, it'll be called Daiashi Harai. This is Hizaguruma. The opponent's Kouchigari changes into a Hizaguruma. Kouchigaeshi is classified as a hand technique, not a foot technique. Uchimata Sukashi. When your opponent attacks with Uchimata, you move your right foot back, turn and twist. The opponent, losing his target, will only hit empty air and fall, drawing a large arc as he does so. Occasionally, you may raise one of your feet up high to dodge the attack. This also is an application of Uchimata Sukashi. Uchimata Sukashi, performed by Katsuhiko Kashiwazaki, the 1981 world champion. Another Uchimata Sukashi, performed by Masao Takahashi at the World Championships in Paris. Olympic champion Shinji Hosokawa performs Uchimata Sukashi at the Pacific Rim Judo Championships. Yama Arashi. For several years after 1886, there was a fierce rivalry between the old-style jiu-jitsu and Jigoro Kano's Kodokan Judo. People of the time went wild with enthusiasm at the Tokyo Police Martial Arts Tournament, which was to decide whether to opt for jiu-jitsu or for judo, when the diminutive Sanshiro Sugata felled his giant of an opponent with Yama Arashi. Shiro Saigo, the sixth Dan, is considered to be the model of the hero of the novel Sanshiro Sugata. Though small in stature, his fierce performance won him the praise. There were no Yama Arashi to speak of before or after Saigo. In December 1922, Master Kano, mourning the death of Saigo, said in the performance of the techniques he excelled in, none among the several million followers could surpass him. So saying, he honoured him by presenting him with the sixth Dan. Yama Arashi is performed by grasping your opponent's collar and sleeve on the same side, lifting him up as in Harai Goshi, then dropping him using the hip. With your right hand placed inside the collar of your opponent, with the thumb inside, push against his right chest. push your opponent down. Then, just as he tries to raise himself, jump in and throw him. The foot movement is similar to that of harai-goshi. Your toes should be put close to your opponent's ankle as you brush it upwards. Simultaneously, lift with the right hand while brushing upwards with the right foot, then throw in a large motion upwards. Or goshi. In or goshi, you pull your opponent forward with your arm around his waist, then throw on your waist. Move in with your hip low. Make your throw only after your opponent's hip is sufficiently close. With your left hand, pull your opponent out off balance, forward to your left. Bring his waist sufficiently close to place him on your hips. Then, with both elbows outstretched, pull him straight up to throw. With your left hand under your opponent's side, as you come to grapple, pull his waist close and perform or-goshi. Here the opponent's hanegoshi is turned into or-goshi. Pull your opponent's waist close as he attacks with a hanegoshi. Step up close with both your feet and throw using the or-goshi technique. This is not utsuri-goshi. Uki-goshi. In uki-goshi, you draw your opponent's waist in close using one of your arms, then throw using the twisting motion of your waist. In the practice form, the throw is made as your opponent attacks, as if to strike. In uki-goshi, you throw in a twisting motion after bending back fully, using your left hip as the fulcrum. Your shoulder is placed deep under your opponent's arm, and your arm secures his waist position parallel to his belt. Look once again at how you bend your back, how your shoulder should be positioned, and how your waist is twisted. Let's see the difference between an or-goshi and uki-goshi. In or-goshi, keep your knees bent and your waist low. Then straighten the knees and make the throw with an upward pulling movement. In uki-goshi, your waist is only lowered shallowly and your lower left hip is made the fulcrum as you twist and throw. This is a rare film showing Professor Kano explaining his favourite technique, uki-goshi, before the practice hall of Tokyo Higher Normal School in the early part of the century. Tsuri-goshi. In tsuri-goshi, you grasp your opponent's belt from behind, then bringing him in close, lift and throw on your hip. You must defend against your opponent's tsuri-komi-goshi while you grasp his belt from under his arm as you throw. In this form of tsuri-goshi, you grasp your opponent's belt over his shoulder. Pulling your opponent forward, you grasp his belt over his shoulder and throw using tsuri-goshi. Throwing as you grasp the front part of your opponent's belt is also an application of the tsuri-goshi technique. It's called a tsuri-goshi only when the belt is grasped in making the throw. Suri Komigoshi. This is the kata form of Suri Komigoshi. The moment your opponent protects himself by bending backwards, lower your hips and making them the fulcrum of your throw, pull him down with both your arms. In randori, you pull your opponent up with both arms and throw him on your hips when moving either forwards or backwards. Take firm hold of the rear of your opponent's jacket when he's bent forward in a defensive posture to throw, pulling him up. This is also Suri Komigoshi. There is an application of Suri Komigoshi which is generally called Sode Suri Komigoshi. By pulling up your opponent's arm, you destroy his balance. You then have a choice of either taking hold of his sleeve opening like this, or taking hold of the elbow section of his sleeve. When grasping the sleeve opening, you sometimes do so by pushing your opponent's hand away. The throw is made when he comes back with the same hand to grasp your jacket. Here's a powerful Suri Komigoshi executed by Khabareli of the Soviet Union at the Kano Cup tournament. The Lausanne World Judo Championship Lightweight Division Finals. Nobuyuki Sato wins with a Sode Suri Komigoshi. Suri Komigoshi shown by Nobutoshi Hikage at the All Japan Judo Championship Tournament. Koshi Guruma. In Koshi Guruma, you grasp your opponent by the neck and throw in a twisting motion with him on your hips. Control your opponent by holding his neck. Place your waist deep under him and push to the side. Koshi Guruma must be executed by holding your opponent's neck. Harai Goshi. In Harai Goshi, you pull your opponent close and throw with your hip and legs in a sweeping motion. The nage no kata form is created by pulling your opponent close by putting a hand under his arm and raising him to destroy his balance. In randori, you seldom put your hand in as shown here. Here the technique is performed by following the motion of your opponent who withdraws. Another chance for using harai goshi presents itself when you pull your opponent out sideways as shown here. The body movement when executing harai goshi varies as when you crisscross and change the position of your feet. For a moment, your opponent mistakes it for a right-hander technique. Then you turn and go into the motion for harai goshi. let's take a look at various forms of haraigoshi from tournament films. This is haraigoshi as performed by Castro of the United States. An All Japan Judo Championship, haraigoshi, performed by Nobutoshi Hikage. The throw is made in a winding motion the moment his opponent comes up close and tries to defend himself by swinging his right foot over. Haraigoshi by Yoshimi Masaki at an All Japan Judo Championship. Hanegoshi. Hanegoshi is a technique of throwing your opponent by bouncing him up using the movement of your hip and foot. Hanegoshi executed in pursuit. It's made the moment your opponent retreats and brings his left foot down. The leg to be used in bouncing your opponent up should be bent a little. You bounce him up around the lower part of his knee. The technique may be used after guiding your opponent sideways. This is Hanegoshi, where you jump in to execute the technique. Pull your opponent downwards, and when he straightens himself up in reaction, jump in to execute this technique. Let's look at the difference between Hanegoshi and Haraigoshi. In Hanegoshi, you bounce your opponent up with your leg bent. In Haraigoshi, your leg is straight as you bounce your opponent up. Uchimata looks similar to Hanegoshi, except you place your leg in between your opponent's legs and bounce him up. Utsurigoshi. Utsurigoshi is a kind of technique used when your opponent attacks with koshiwaza, to raise him up and throw him on your hips. This is an utsurigoshi technique which originates from the opponent's hanegoshi. This is utsurigoshi, which started out as an uchimata by the opponent. You completely raise your opponent up by the waist and opening outwards, throw after moving him over on your hips. It can also be executed after your opponent attacks with an o sotogari. In this case, you draw your foot a moment before he executes his o sotogari. The second World Cup tournament. Vesniak of the Soviet Union wins with Utsuri Goshi. Ushiro Goshi. This is the throw to use when your opponent attacks with Koshiwaza. You lift your opponent up and throw him down in front of you. This Ushiro Goshi has developed from the opponent's Hane Goshi. Ushiro Goshi executed just as your opponent tries to defend himself by curling his feet around yours. When changing into Ushiro Goshi, your opponent may try defending himself by attacking your foot, as in Ouchigari. You then lift up the foot that's been attacked, hoist him up, then throw him down. This is in case your opponent defends himself using something like Kouchigari. If your opponent defends himself by using Kouchigari from inside, lift your foot that's been attacked, hoist him up, and throw him down. When your opponent attacks with Osotogari, push his waist up with your leg as you throw him down. Ushiro Goshi resulting from your opponent's Hane Goshi. You can also execute the technique like this without holding your opponent's hip, but simply lifting it up by using your left foot. These different follow-on techniques are all called Ushiro Goshi. Dakiage. When on the floor, you grasp your opponent's belt to make him bend over. Then, with your arms crossed, grip both lapels to bring him near. Then, standing up on both legs, raise him up at once deftly to the shoulder level. This technique is dangerous if your opponent is dropped after being raised up, so that the effect of the throw was recognized only in 1926. In those days, an Ippon was declared when you succeeded in raising your opponent up to the shoulder high level at one go. But today, the match is suspended with a call of mate. The effect of the technique is not recognized. Hizaguruma. Hizaguruma is a technique of supporting your opponent's knee with your foot as you throw. As your opponent tries to step forward, place the sole of your foot on his knee. Your opponent will turn and fall in a twisting motion. Hizaguruma performed after transferring your right hand from his left lapel to mid-sleeve. Another method, where your opponent's knee is bent. Step forward. Execute the technique as if trying to bend your opponent's knee. He then falls in a twisting motion. Hizaguruma following on from your opponent's Kouchigari. Raise your attacked foot and follow on with a Hizaguruma. This is not Kouchigaishi, however. Sasae Tsurikomiashi. Sasae Tsurikomiashi is executed by putting the sole of your foot on your opponent's ankle and throwing with that as the fulcrum. This is when your opponent has stepped forward. This is when you first lightly slap the inside of your opponent's left foot before executing the technique. The aim of this is to destroy your opponent's balance toward the tip of his right foot as you slap his foot from inside. Sasae Tsurikomiyashi made to look like O Sotogari. When O Sotogari is executed, your opponent defends by moving his weight forward in reaction. Turn your body at that moment, support with your foot as you throw. Sasae Tsurikomiyashi, executed by Anton Heysink of the Netherlands, the victor of the Tokyo Olympics. Another Sasae Tsurikomiyashi, as performed by Chonosuke Takagi, the winner of the World Championships in Lausanne. All Japan champion Naoya Ogawa performs Sasae Tsurikomiyashi. Ogawa grapples his opponent from his left side, brings him in tight using both hands in a characteristically powerful twisting motion. Harai Tsurikomiyashi. In Harai Tsurikomiyashi, you can throw your opponent by a sweeping blow to the rear of his foot. Here, the right foot of the opponent is swept away as he tries to retreat, and then he's thrown. You slap at the inside of the foot of your opponent as he tries to retreat to destroy his balance towards the tip of his right foot, then sweep him off his feet. Let's compare these two techniques. In Sasae Tsurikomiyashi, you support your opponent's foot as you throw. In Harai Tsurikomiyashi, you slap at your opponent's feet as you make your throw. Sasae and Harai are similar in form, but are different in that one has the Sasaeru, or supporting motion, whereas the other has the Harai Ageru, or sweeping motion. Deashi Harai. In Deashi Harai, you sweep away one of your opponent's feet that's moved forward. When your opponent steps forward with his right foot, you open up with your right and sweep using your left foot. Here you sweep the retreating right foot of the opponent who's trying to move back. Here you lead your opponent around and sweep his right foot as he steps forward. This is following on from Hizaguruma. When you try Hizaguruma, your opponent reciprocates stepping forward with his right foot. You then sweep away that right foot. In another instance, you release your opponent's hand as he pulls, and using your own hand, bring his foot forward, which you can then sweep away. At the Seoul World Championships, Masaki triumphs over Rashwan with an Ippon using Deashi Harai. A an All Japan Judo Championship. Look at the marvelously well-timed Daiashi Harai performed by Masaki. At the Kano Cup tournament, Hiromitsu Takano executes a Daiashi Harai. Okuriyashi Harai. Okuriyashi Harai is a technique where you sweep away both of your opponent's feet as you throw him. You lead your opponent around and sweep away both his feet. In Okuriyashi Harai, you sweep away both your opponent's feet as they're together. Okuriyashi Harai performed in two steps. You step in and sweep away the retreating foot of your opponent. Let's compare similar techniques. In Okuriyashi Harai, you sweep away both your opponent's feet together. In Daiashi Harai, you sweep away your opponent's foot as he steps forward. In Harai Tsurikomiyashi, you sweep away your opponent's foot as it retreats towards the far corner. We decide the technique used according to these criteria. Tsubame Gaeshi. Tsubame Gaeshi is a technique of throwing your opponent by reversing his foot sweep into your own. Shift directly to your right or left. If your opponent attacks with Daiashi Harai or Okuriyashi Harai, you dodge it and turn it into Tsubame Gaeshi. Even when moving back, you can also do likewise. Kosoto Gari. Changing your opponent's Taiotoshi into Kosoto Gari. Dodging your opponent's Taiotoshi, make him off balance, standing on both his heels, then cut him down in the direction of his toes using the back of your feet. Your foot will be placed on roughly the same line as your opponent's. When you're clipping, you should do so from your opponent's heels in the direction of his toes, as if rubbing the surface of the mat. Your opponent should fall suddenly on the spot. Kosoto Gari, performed by Shozo Fuji, a former middleweight class world champion. He catches his opponent with Kosoto Gari just as he comes back from applying a right side Osoto Gari. Kosoto Gake. Kosoto Gake is a technique of throwing your opponent in a kind of pulling up motion. Sometimes the sole of the foot, at other times the leg is used for clipping. As the opponent withdraws his left foot, shifting his weight onto his other foot, you make him fall, hooking with your leg. You first try an uchimata. Then the moment your opponent tries to defend himself, leaning backward, you turn it into Kosoto Gake. Here you take hold of the rear collar to bring your opponent in close, push him back to go off balance, then hook and make him fall. Now let's see the differences between similar techniques. In Kosotogari, you step in close to the side of your opponent, make him lose balance on his heel and clip him down. In Daiashi Harai, the moment your opponent's foot is about to touch the mat, or when his foot is about to be lifted off the mat, you sweep his foot away to make him fall. In Kosotogake, you make your opponent lose his balance by making him stand on his heels as you face him directly. Clip as if to pull your opponent up and backwards as you throw him. World champion Naoya Ogawa shows off Kosotogake, which is his favorite technique. This is a two-stage Kosotogake, performed by Yoshimi Masaki. Marshall of the USA executes Kosotogake, having secured the rear collar and pulled his opponent in close. Or Sotogari. Pull the right leg of your opponent out, then clip him down the moment it touches the mat. Pull his left leg out and cut down on his right leg. Osotogari from a harai tsurikomiyashi. As your opponent advances to defend himself, cut down on his right leg. Another method is to put your arm under your opponent's and holding his waist from the rear to cut him down. Another is to pull your opponent up by the front of his belt and execute a clip upwards. Here you push your opponent's elbow to make him lose balance and cut him down to the rear. An All-Japan Judo Championship. Yasuhiro Yamashita executes a convincing Osotogari. Again, at an All-Japan Judo Championship, Osotogari following on from a Harai Goshi performed by Hiromi Masaki. The 1987 World Judo Championships. Hirotaka Okada performs a magnificent Osotogari. Osoto Otoshi. Osoto Otoshi is made by pushing down your opponent by sliding your leg down his rear waist. In Osoto Otoshi, your opponent's foot must be on the matting as you make the sliding clip. Here you see Osoto Otoshi made with the opponent's neck on your arm. Let's look at the differences between Osotogari and Osoto Otoshi. If your opponent's foot goes up in the air, it's Osotogari. If your opponent's leg remains on the matting as you sweep and he goes down, it's an osoto otoshi. At the World Judo Championships, Hitoshi Saito makes osoto otoshi. Osoto guruma. In osoto guruma, you begin your throw as in osoto gari, but cut both your opponent's legs as you twist him down. Sometimes it's done in two movements. In a variation of this, you step behind both your opponent's legs with your right leg and make him fall, as in Taiotoshi. Osoto Gaeshi. As your opponent steps in trying to execute osoto gari, you instead cut him down at that moment using the same throw. Here, the opponent's osoto gari is returned after a short delay. As you defend yourself against your opponent's osoto gari by pulling back your right foot, you counter with an osoto gari. As you defend yourself against your opponent's osoto gari by pulling back your left foot, you counter with a twist. As you defend against your opponent's osoto gari by pulling back your left foot, you counter as if in osoto gaeshi. Another example where an opportunity to counter came still later. Oguruma. Oguruma is a technique where you make your throw by turning your opponent around your leg as an axis. Placing your leg near the lower abdomen of your opponent to use as an axis, you turn him around and throw. Execute Hizaguruma, and the moment your opponent counters with his right foot, follow on with a Oguruma. Oguruma was one of the favorite techniques of the 10th Dan, Kyuzo Mifune. He's captured the moment his opponent tries to step forward on his right foot. Ashiguruma. In Ashiguruma, you place your foot on your opponent's knee and throw with that as an axis. It's the same principle as Hizaguruma. Here, an osoto gari is followed by ashiguruma. First, you execute osoto gari. When your opponent responds by withdrawing his left foot, you follow with ashiguruma. Let's see the difference between osoto gari and ashiguruma. when you use osotogari, your opponent falls directly to the rear. With ashiguruma, your opponent twists and falls forward. The name of the technique is decided by looking closely at these points. Yamashita wins with ashiguruma at the 1955 All Japan Judo Championships. Uchimata. In using the uchimata technique, you first pull your opponent forward. Then just when his weight shifts to his left foot as he moves forward, you throw by sweeping up from between his legs. Here you jump in to make your throw the moment your opponent withdraws his foot and touches the mat. Pull your opponent forward to make him assume jigotai, or a self-defense position. Then jump in and apply uchimata just as he raises himself. This is a method generally known as ken-ken uchimata. You sweep with your left leg to destroy your opponent's balance and throw. An uchimata after having switched feet. The movement is similar to that of harai goshi and oguruma. The method used is to pull your opponent sideways, then sweep up on the leg he steps out on. First, you make a move, as in performing ouchigari. Then it's transformed into uchimata. In this situation, the objective is to cause your opponent to open up his legs and lean forward off balance. If your opponent defends himself by going down on one knee, he's still judged to be standing, and the uchimata is recognized. Uchimata, performed by Seiki Nosei of Japan. Pesniak of the USSR follows an opponent in to perform an uchimata. Uchimata performed by Olympic champion Yamashita. Another Olympic champion, Hitoshi Saito, performs a variation uchimata. When his opponent counters by taking hold of Saito's knee with his right hand, Saito, turning left, transforms the movement into an uchimata. An uchimata by Sumio Endo, where he makes use of the twisting of his body. Uchimata gaishi. In uchimata gaishi, when your opponent attacks with uchimata, you counter by cutting back on his pivotal foot. The tip throw made 大内刈り。Pull your opponent's foot forward. Then just as he tries to put his weight on that foot, clip his foot and make him fall. Here, the opponent's foot is being clipped as he tries to retreat. Here, the opponent is pulled out sideways, then his foot is clipped as if to open it further out. Here, the opponent is pulled in close, then clipped the moment he tries to rise up. Here, when the opponent tries to get away by raising his foot, he's pushed forward and cut down off balance. Here, his leg is grabbed as you clip. In the World Championships, Vachon of France performs an Ouchi Gari. Ouchi Gari performed by Yamashita. At the finals of the second Kano Cup tournament, Katsuhiko Kashiwazaki performs an Ouchi Gari, taking hold of his opponent's foot. Ouchi Gaeshi. Ouchi Gaeshi is a technique of countering your opponent's Ouchi Gari with an Ouchi Gari of your own. There are two ways of countering. One is to clip the foot that's clipping you, and the other is to clip your opponent's pivotal foot. Here, the opponent's foot is clipped back as he tries to clip you. Here, you counter by clipping both your opponent's attacking foot as well as his pivotal foot at the same time. Dodge your opponent's Ouchi Gari and counter with a twisting motion. This is also Ouchi Gaeshi. Use your opponent's force to return the attack by twisting to the right. First dodging your opponent's Ouchi Gari, then throwing and twisting to your left. Hisao Matsui performs an Ouchi Gari. Preschel of West Germany performs an Ouchi Gaeshi as they rise from the Newaza position. Ouchi Gari. In Ouchi Gari, You pull your opponent's foot forward, then you clip just as his foot comes down on the mat. In this instance, you cut down on the retreating foot of your opponent. Here, Kochigari is performed by pulling the opponent off sideways, and here you cause your opponent to open his feet wide and clip after subduing his defense. Another method is to clip holding one of your opponent's feet. You may sometimes turn around once as you take hold of your opponent's foot and make him fall. Bergmans of Belgium performs Kochigari from an uchimata position. Hitoshi Saito at the 1988 All Japan Weight Class Championships. He performs Kochigari, taking hold of his opponent's leg. Hane Goshi Gaeshi. There are two ways of performing Hane Goshi Gaeshi. One is a leg technique whereby you reap the pivotal foot of your opponent, and another is a hip technique of pushing up with the hip and twisting before countering. At times you hold the opponent's waist and reap your opponent's pivotal foot. With your hip, you bounce your opponent up in a large motion, then throw, twisting with both hands. When bouncing your opponent with your hip, you may at times simultaneously sweep upwards using your leg. Harai Goshi Gaeshi. In Harai Goshi Gaeshi, you counter by reaping your opponent's pivotal foot for executing Harai Goshi. Just as your opponent attacks with Harai Goshi, you counter by extending your hips, then reap his pivotal foot to make him fall. The technique you use in countering, holding your opponent's hips, is also Harai Goshi Gaeshi. Here the opponent's hips are being held, but as the counter action is reaping his pivotal foot, it's not Ushiro Goshi. Ushiro Goshi is a technique where you raise your opponent up, holding him by the hip and letting him fall. Tomoe Nage. In Tomoe Nage, you drop backwards while putting a foot on your opponent's lower abdomen and throw him back over your head. Here, the technique is applied just as soon as your opponent steps forward and tries to put his weight on his foot. Here, the opponent is pulled out forward at a slight angle as the technique is applied. This is the way you apply the technique when your opponent is in a right-handed position, making him go off balance on his toes and making him fall to his right as you throw. Here, the throw is made over your head when your opponent is in the right-handed position. Here, the opponent is thrown by pushing him up using both feet. At the Seoul World Championships, Shinji Hosokawa clinches victory with a tomoe nage. Yusuke Yamamoto at the third Kano Cup tournament. A tomoe nage throwing to the right. At the Moscow World Championship, Kenichi Haraguchi executes a tomoe nage, turning himself over as well. Uranage. The principle behind this form is to use the force of your opponent as you dodge his striking motion and to throw him, lifting him up on your hip as you sacrifice yourself by falling backward. Here, the opponent's hanegoshi is transformed into an uranage. As the opponent attacks with a hanegoshi, hold his hips and bring him close and throw him directly behind over your shoulder. Another way is to hold and raise your opponent up from the front, then leaning back, throw by sacrificing yourself. An All-Japan Judo Championship. Here, Sumio Endo performs uranage, which is a transformation of his opponent's kouchigari. Sumigaeshi. You start with both sides grappling in a defensive position. The technique was already in existence in Koryu, one of the older schools of Jiu-Jitsu, and the exact same form has been handed down. In the present-day Dandori, we do not start directly from such a position. In Sumigaeshi, you fall backwards in a self-sacrificing movement. Place the instep of your right foot in the crook of his left knee and lift him up over your head. You pull your opponent forward, grasping his rear collar to execute sumigaeshi. Here it's done by grasping your opponent's rear collar or his back and starts with uchimata. Here it's a quick turn around from the uchimata position, followed on with sumigaeshi. Sumigaeshi is one of the favorite techniques of Verichev of the Soviet Union. Hikkomigaeshi. Hikkomigaeshi is another Koryu technique. First, grapple in the defensive posture, holding your opponent's right arm with both arms. Fall down and place your right foot on your opponent's right inner thigh. Then throw over your right shoulder. This was the original Hikkomigaeshi. In a dandari situation, the throw is often made by pulling your opponent in close, holding his belt at the rear, then by throwing him, falling down in a self-sacrificing motion. The place where your foot is applied varies. There's no set place. This is the method of throwing by falling to your side. In this case, it becomes yokostemiwaza. You pull your opponent's belt at the rear close and throw by falling sideways in a self-sacrificing motion. Let's see the differences between this and a sumigaeshi, which look very much alike. In sumigaeshi, you throw by grasping the rear collar of your opponent. In hikkomigaeshi, you throw by grasping the rear part of your opponent's belt. The difference between the two may be judged by whether you hold your opponent's belt or not. Hikkomigaeshi is one of the favorite techniques of Katsuhiko Kashiwazaki. He used it in the 1981 World Championships. Tawara Gaeshi. In Tawara Gaeshi, you hold your opponent from above to pull him close, then throw as you fall face up in a self-sacrificing motion. In this situation, your opponent defends himself by leaning forward. This Tawara Gaeshi follows upon the opponent's Morote Gari. When your opponent jumps in close to execute Morote Gari, you pull your feet back, drop your hip low to defend yourself, then counter. Ukiwaza. In ukiwaza, you step sideways on one foot, sacrificing your balance, and throw your opponent in the direction of your foot. Around 1883, when the nage no kata form of the throw was established, the technique was performed starting with grappling in the self-defense posture. This is ukiwaza, performed by pulling the opponent forward. This ukiwaza is performed by stepping in with your right foot when your opponent withdraws his left foot. At times, you might assume an oblique defensive posture after pulling your opponent forward by grasping his rear collar and a sleeve and throw from a self-sacrificing posture. This is a technique of following on from kataguruma to ukiwaza. In this technique, as you're sacrificing yourself in making the throw, it is not kataguruma. The opponent is pulled by rolling up his right arm under your left arm, then thrown, twisting your body to the left. Yoko otoshi. In yoko otoshi, you step to one side and throw your opponent directly to one side in a sacrificing motion. Observe the off-balancing to the side and sacrificing motion. Pull your opponent to one side, make him go off balance, then throw, sacrificing yourself, as you can see, in a yoko otoshi, off balancing and throwing are done to the side. Tani otoshi. In tani otoshi, you step behind both legs of your opponent in a sacrificing motion, then throw him down directly behind. If you can push his elbow up, it becomes even more easy to make him go off balance and fall backwards. Here, Kuchiki Daoshi is transformed into Tani Otoshi. On occasions when Kuchiki Daoshi cannot be executed, you might step in, throwing in a self-sacrificing motion. This also is a kind of Tani Otoshi. Here you hold your opponent's right arm under your left arm. You perform Tani Otoshi, sacrificing yourself. Take a look at a different kind of Tani Otoshi. Step in behind both your opponent's legs, leaning to force him to fall. Let's look at these three similar techniques. In ukiwaza, you make your opponent lose his balance forward. He's thrown in that direction. In yoko otoshi, you make your opponent lose his balance to the side. He's thrown in that direction. In tani otoshi, you make your opponent lose his balance backward, and he's thrown in that direction. Observe Nobutoshi Hikage, a world champion for 1983 and 85, use his favorite technique, Tani Otoshi. Yoko Watare. In Yoko Watare, you step in with both of your feet next to your opponent's feet, then throw him over your body, sacrificing yourself. The moment your opponent's feet are together, sacrifice yourself and throw him above your body. Here, the opponent's ogoshi is transformed into a Yoko Watare. As soon as your opponent attacks with ogoshi, you open sideways and turn it into a yoko wakare. Transforming your opponent's deashi harai. When your opponent attacks with deashi harai, step up close and sacrificing yourself, throw sideways with a yoko wakare. Yoko wakare can also be performed as mastemi waza on the floor. Yoko gake. When practicing the kata, destroy your opponent's balance in about 2.5 steps, then throw, sacrificing yourself. In this technique, it's important to make your opponent go off balance till he's supported only by his toes. You sweep, thrusting powerfully with your sole just underneath your opponent's ankle from the front, then sacrificing yourself, throw him parallel to your body. Because yoko gake is extremely difficult to set up, it's hardly ever used in dandori. You sometimes see it used in conjunction with sasae tsurikomi ashi in practice. The opponent falls after being thrown in a large whirl. This, too, is an application of yokogake. Dakiwakare. In fighting on the mat, if your opponent does not get up, you can raise and hold him up from the side, then twisting, throw over your body. It appears that in the early days of judo, the effect of this technique was allowed even if you were on a mat. However, under the present system of judging, the effect of the throw is no longer recognized. Here, standing fight becomes dakiwakare. When your opponent attacks with an uchimata, you might try catching him from the rear to apply another technique. Then, when he lets down both of his hands and escapes, you can apply dakiwakare. The effect of the technique is recognized in this case. Yokoguruma. If you try throwing your opponent with an uranage as he comes at you, he defends himself by twisting. Put your right foot between both his feet at that moment and throw, sacrificing yourself. Here, the opponent's hanegoshi is turned into this technique. Here's the way to apply it, following on from taneotoshi. The moment your opponent bends forward to defend himself against taneotoshi, then you follow with this. Soto makikomi. In soto makikomi, hold your opponent's arm under your arm. Step in close with your hips, then turning, throw him over your body in a wrapping motion. Place your hip close to the opponent to use as an axis in the throw. This is the basic principle of soto makikomi. Placing your hip next to your opponent, but not so deep, and throwing him. This is also soto makikomi. Here's soto makikomi, where you first step in with your feet. You can also step sideways in a large motion outside your opponent's right foot to wrap him around. When applying hanegoshi or haraigoshi, your opponent may defend himself by holding close to you. It may be possible to throw him using the wrapping technique. Uchi makikomi. Uchi makikomi is similar to ippon seoi nage. Grasp your opponent by the arm and twist sideways to wrap him around you. Use your hip as an axis. Twist and throw in a wrapping motion. This is the basis of uchi makikomi. Here's Uchimaki Komi, where you step out on your right foot to set it up. Here's Uchimaki Komi after you've made your opponent retreat. Here you follow on from Ippon Seoi Nage. The moment your opponent defends himself by turning away, you grasp his neck with an arm and pull, wrapping him around you. We distinguish between Seoi Nage and Uchimaki Komi by whether you carried your opponent on your shoulder or simply wrapped him around you as you controlled his arm. Hanemaki Komi. In Hanemaki Komi, you throw in a wrapping motion as you lift your opponent up with Hanegoshi. There are two methods of executing this throw. The first is to lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm. The second method is to lift your opponent up with Hanegoshi, then wrap him around you. There's a difference in the timing of when you take hold of your opponent's arm. In this case, the opponent's collar has simply been grasped and he's not been wrapped around. This is Hanegoshi, not Hanemaki Komi. Harai Maki Komi. In Harai Maki Komi, you lift your opponent up using Harai Goshi, then throw, wrapping him around you. There are two ways to throw. In the first method, lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm like this. Another method is to lift your opponent up with Harai Goshi, then place his arm under yours to wrap him around you. There's a difference in the timing of when you grasp your opponent's arm. Again, in this case, the opponent's collar has simply been grasped and he's not been wrapped around. This is Harai Goshi, not Harai Maki Komi. Watch this breathtaking Harai Maki Komi as executed by Sumio Endo at the World Championships in Paris. Uchimata Maki Komi. In Uchimata Maki Komi, you lift your opponent up using Uchimata, then throw, wrapping him around you. There are two ways to make the throw. The first is to lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm. The second method is to lift your opponent up with Uchimata, then wrap him around you and throw. Please observe carefully the timing of grasping the opponent's arm under yours. Sumio Endo performs Uchimata Maki Komi at the All Japan Judo Championships. Osoto Maki Komi. Osoto Makikomi starts with one of the Osoto Gari family of techniques, followed by either an outer or inner wraparound throw. In the first case, following your opponent's defense of an Osoto Gari, you throw by wrapping him around you in an outward direction. From an Osoto Gari, you lean on your opponent and throw him, wrapping him outwards. The final technique used is Soto Makikomi, but as it follows Osoto Gari, the throw is called Osoto Makikomi. In the second case, you start out with Osoto Gari, where you place your right arm underneath your opponent's right arm. As he defends himself, you counter by throwing forward, by wrapping him around yours, as in Uchi Makikomi. The final technique appears to be Uchi Makikomi, but as it follows on Osoto Gari, it is called Osoto Makikomi. Observe Osoto Makikomi by an Olympic champion, Zeissenbacher. Kani Basami. Kani Basami is a technique of throwing where you sandwich your opponent's body using both your feet. As soon as your feet are on a line with your opponent's, sandwich his abdomen and legs between your legs and throw in a sacrificing movement. See how Oguruma is followed by Kani Basami. As you attack with Oguruma, your opponent tries to grasp your ankle to trip you. At that moment, follow with Kani Basami. At an All Japan Championship, Hirotoshi Watanabe attempts Kani Basami on Yamashita. Kawazu Gake. Kawazu Gake is considered dangerous as you fall together with your opponent. It's prohibited in a tournament. In Kawazu Gake, you pull your opponent's neck close and hook one of his feet from inside. As you lean back, you throw both yourself and your opponent at the same time. Quite often, it's very difficult to judge the name of the technique as it's applied. Also, with more research and development, new techniques may well be born. However, the name will be chosen from one of the 65 throws, depending on the principle behind the technique used. We hope this video will help you to understand the classifications and names of the techniques, their variations, as well as the principles behind the form and the execution of the throws. This is Jigoro Kano, the founder of the Kodokan Judo. Professor Jigoro Kano learned the traditional Japanese martial art, Jujutsu, and he transformed it into something new, with an objective and practicing methods appropriate to the new era. In 1882, he named it Kodokan Judo. Judo, which is practiced around the world, is in fact Kodokan Judo. Judo, which Professor Kano promoted with all his might for some 50 years, later became widespread and eagerly pursued in over 150 nations of the world, eventually achieving recognition as an Olympic event. Techniques of judo can be divided into three kinds: nagewaza, katamewaza, and atemiwaza. And there are two ways of practice: randori and kata. Nagewaza can be divided into tachiwaza and stemiwaza. For each technique, let us now show you the basics and applications, as well as differences between techniques which look alike. Seoi nage. There are two types of seoi nage: morote seoi nage and ippon seoi nage. The hands are used differently when lifting your opponent. This is morote seoi nage. Put your right elbow underneath the side of your opponent's body as you lift him. You grasp one side of your opponent's collar and sleeve. The technique used in throwing him is an application of morote seoi nage. This is ippon seoi nage. You hold and control one of the arms of your opponent as you lift and throw him. Seoi nage with your arm turned. In ippon seoi nage, you sometimes extend one of your legs wide to the outside of your opponent's right leg. Morote seoi nage, executed with a leg extended wide to the outside. This technique is an application of seoi nage and is not taiotoshi. Ippon seoi nage. You throw your opponent by turning him over on top of you. This is ippon seoi nage, executed by grasping your opponent's left arm. The key is to control your opponent's left arm by winding it in under the side of your body. Now let's look at various seoi nage from different contests. Yusuke Yamamoto, the 1987 world champion in the 65 kilogram class. Seoi nage executed by Sumio Endo, a former world champion in the heavyweight class. It's his favorite technique. A beautiful ippon seoi nage executed by Masao Takahashi at a world championships. At the Kano Cup International Tournament, Toshiko Koga shows off his favorite technique, ippon seoi. Seoi otoshi. Seoi Otoshi is a throwing technique where you take your opponent on your back and pull him straight down. As you throw, you can do so either with one knee or both knees on the floor. Seoi Otoshi, moving from an Ippon Seoi Nage position. In Seoi Nage, you throw your opponent by lifting him over, but in Seoi Otoshi, you throw him by pulling him down over you. Seoi Otoshi on both knees. Whether it's Seoi Nage or Seoi Otoshi is decided by whether your opponent was lifted or pulled over. This is Seoi Nage with both knees on the floor. We judge so because after going down on both knees, the throw was made by raising the hip and hoisting the opponent's frame. Seoi Otoshi by Yoshiyuki Matsuoka, the 65kg class champion at the Los Angeles Olympics. Tai Otoshi. There are various ways of executing Tai Otoshi depending on the situation. This is Tai Otoshi executed by drawing the opponent out. This is a tailing Tai Otoshi, executed the moment the opponent moves his leg back. In this Tai Otoshi, the opponent has been drawn out sideways. There are cases where Tai Otoshi is executed by grabbing one side of the collar. Double motion Tai Otoshi. It was executed first of all by lightly kicking the inside of the opponent's foot to make him lose balance. In another instance, you might cross your opponent's arms when executing the throw. By twisting your opponent's arms, his body goes off balance and his resistance is stopped. Hiromitsu Takano, the winner of the Kano Cup, here shows off a spirited Tai Otoshi. At the World Judo Championships in Seoul, Hitoshi Sugai catches Ha Hong-ju of Korea just as they establish their grip, a brilliant Tai Otoshi. Kataguruma. Kataguruma is a technique in which you haul your opponent up above you as you throw. As you can see, the throw is generally made by throwing your opponent down toward the tip of your foot. In kataguruma, the throw can be made in any number of directions after you raise your opponent up. In this case, the opponent is thrown directly in front. It appears that this kind of throw was often used in the early days of modern judo. In this kataguruma, the body of the opponent is raised up high, and the throw is then made by bending backwards. The direction of the throws may differ, but these are all considered kataguruma, and the effect of the throw is recognized. Here you enter low on one knee, raise your opponent up and throw him down. Kataguruma with different forms include this as well. As in Morotegari, you raise your opponent up holding both his legs, then stretching backwards, throw him down. This form is hardly ever seen nowadays, but was apparently one of the techniques in the older schools of Jujutsu. Uki-otoshi. The tori, or active partner, pulls the uke, or passive partner, forward, goes down on one knee, and pulls him down in front. The aim of practicing kata, or form, is to make students realize the principle behind the technique. In uki-otoshi, you sometimes step in the moment your opponent steps forward with his left foot, then execute your throw by pulling him off balance to one side of you. When your right hand is grasping the middle of the sleeve like this, you can force him to go off balance by pushing up on his elbow. Have another look. Dodging your opponent's osotogari by pulling back your leg, turn aside and then throw. This is also uki-otoshi. Sumi-otoshi. Sumi-otoshi is a throwing technique in which you shake your opponent off balance into the rear corner, then throw him by thrusting him down. Using your right hand, you pull up your opponent by grasping his left collar. You make your opponent lose balance by causing him to raise his left foot and shift his weight to his right heel. In another instance, you shift your grip from his left collar to the middle of his sleeve. You then push his elbow up to make him lose balance. Sumi-otoshi and uki-otoshi make up a pair. Let's now look at the difference between sumi-otoshi and uki-otoshi. In sumi-otoshi, you push and throw your opponent down to the rear. In uki-otoshi, you pull and throw your opponent down to the front. The direction of off-balancing and throwing your opponent differs. Sumi-otoshi was one of the favorite techniques of Kyuzo Mifune, the 10th Dan. Pay close attention to the principle of the technique, where you force your opponent's left foot to come forward and throw him down in a backward direction. Sukui Nage. Originally in Sukui Nage, you first pushed your opponent back to make him lose balance, then lifted him up and threw him in a backward direction. This technique is not at all seen in recent tournaments. In a tournament, the technique of placing a hand underneath your opponent's thigh and lifting him up is often used. When your opponent tries a harai-goshi, you should pull your foot back to open yourself up for an attack, then put your hand in from behind your opponent to lift him up and throw him down. Similarly, when your opponent comes at you with an osotogari, then you should again put your hand in from behind and throw. Again, When he attempts an uchimata, you can evade his motion, then putting your hand in from behind, transform it into a sukuinage. On occasion, you may throw using your hips as you lift your opponent. Another way is to lift your opponent as he tries a hanegoshi, then throw by brushing aside his pivot leg. This time, the opponent is lifted by putting a hand in from the front. When your opponent tries osotogari, pull your foot back, then as you do so, put your hand in from the front and lift him up. The final of the 1976 All Japan Championships. Sumio Endo wins with a sukuinage. At the Kobe Universiad Competition 65kg Finals, Yun of Korea performs a sukuinage. Obi Otoshi. Obi Otoshi can be considered a kind of sukuinage. It is one of the techniques of jujutsu, the traditional martial art. Grasp the front part of your opponent's belt. Push him directly back to cause him to lose balance, lift him from the side, and throw him down towards the rear. The principle of obi otoshi is very much like that of sukuinage. Obi otoshi is hardly ever used in modern tournaments, but is one of the techniques used in free exercises of Kodokan Judo. Morote gari. Morote gari is often used in a competition. There are different ways of starting morote gari. In this case, you catch your opponent the moment you come to grapple with him. This is morote gari where you first pull your opponent forward. In this case, seoinage turns into a morote gari. When you attempt seoinage, your opponent will react by bending backwards. Morote gari is then performed without a pause. In following on from a seoinage, you sometimes make one complete turn, as you can see here. This also is an application of morote gari. Here you make your opponent fall by grasping one of his feet using both hands. Morote gari performed by Kim Jae-yup of Korea, the 1987 world champion in the 60kg class. Kuchiki daoshi. Kuchiki daoshi is a technique in which you take your opponent's leg and push him down backwards. It's often used in a tournament. You push your opponent down by taking hold of his leg, but sometimes it's executed from the inside as well as from the outside. In Kuchiki Daoshi, you may simply grasp the other's leg, or you may change it into either from your own or your opponent's technique. Here you turn from seoi nage and grasp your opponent's leg from inside. This is a follow-on technique starting from kataguruma. A kataguruma is attempted, but as your opponent defends himself by shifting his weight backwards, the throw is made by grasping his leg from inside. This time we start with the opponent's osotogari. When the opponent attacks with osotogari, defend yourself by opening up, turning sideways. As you do so, catch him from inside his legs to make him fall. Here you down your opponent by catching his leg from outside. When you perform kochigari, your opponent counters by raising the foot that's been swept from the side. Grasp his leg from outside at that moment to make him fall. This time, continuing from ochigari. The moment your opponent raises his foot to counter the move, you catch his leg from outside to drop him. Look closely at the movement of the right hand. This is not seoi nage, but kuchiki daoshi. A continuous movement is made from a seoi nage, and your opponent is made to fall with the right hand on the outside of his leg. Turning your opponent's kizaguruma into this technique. Catching the foot of your opponent as he attempts kizaguruma, push him down with your left hand to make him fall. Kuchiki daoshi, performed by Nagy Szolimos of Hungary at the World Championships. Kibis gaeshi. Kibis gaeshi is a technique in which you fell your opponent by taking hold of his heel. There are two ways of performing kibis gaeshi. Either by grasping the inside of your opponent's heel, or by grasping the outside. First, make seoi nage, then turn once to face your opponent to follow on to kibis gaeshi. First, grasping your opponent's heel from outside. Catch your opponent's heel from outside as he tries to withdraw, then cut him down by pushing with your left hand. In the following case too, you grasp the heel from outside. From kochigari, you make your opponent fall by taking the heel of the raised foot from outside. Changing your opponent's kizaguruma into this technique. When your opponent attacks with a kizaguruma, take his heel from outside to cut him down. Let's compare techniques. In kuchiki daoshi, you push your opponent down by putting your hand on his leg. In kibisgaeshi, you grasp your opponent's heel and cut him right down on the spot. Kouchigaeshi. In Kouchigaeshi, you dodge your opponent's Kouchigari, then drop him by twisting to either right or left. When your opponent attacks with a Kouchigari, you evade by raising the foot that's been struck, then make a throw by twisting him to the left. This time, twisting to the right. Look closely at how you evade the attack and how you make the twist. This is Daiashi Harai, brushing off the starting move. When the Kouchigari of your opponent is brushed off like this, it'll be called Daiashi Harai. This is Hizaguruma. The opponent's Kouchigari changes into a Hizaguruma. Kouchigaeshi is classified as a hand technique, not a foot technique. Uchimata Sukashi. When your opponent attacks with Uchimata, you move your right foot back, turn and twist. The opponent, losing his target, will only hit empty air and fall, drawing a large arc as he does so. Occasionally, you may raise one of your feet up high to dodge the attack. This also is an application of Uchimata Sukashi. Uchimata Sukashi, performed by Katsuhiko Kashiwazaki, the 1981 world champion. Another Uchimata Sukashi, performed by Masao Takahashi at the World Championships in Paris. Olympic champion Shinji Hosokawa performs Uchimata Sukashi at the Pacific Rim Judo Championships. Yama Arashi. For several years after 1886, there was a fierce rivalry between the old-style jiu-jitsu and Jigoro Kano's Kodokan Judo. People of the time went wild with enthusiasm at the Tokyo Police Martial Arts Tournament, which was to decide whether to opt for jiu-jitsu or for judo, when the diminutive Sanshiro Sugata felled his giant of an opponent with Yama Arashi. Shiro Saigo, the sixth Dan, is considered to be the model of the hero of the novel Sanshiro Sugata. Though small in stature, his fierce performance won him the praise. There were no Yama Arashi to speak of before or after Saigo. In December 1922, Master Kano, mourning the death of Saigo, said in the performance of the techniques he excelled in, none among the several million followers could surpass him. So saying, he honored him by presenting him with the sixth Dan. Yama Arashi is performed by grasping your opponent's collar and sleeve on the same side, lifting him up as in Harai Goshi, then dropping him using the hip. With your right hand placed inside the collar of your opponent, with the thumb inside, push against his right chest. push your opponent down. Then, just as he tries to raise himself, jump in and throw him. The foot movement is similar to that of haraigoshi. Your toes should be put close to your opponent's ankle as you brush it upwards. Simultaneously, lift with the right hand while brushing upwards with the right foot, then throw in a large motion upwards. Ogoshi. In ogoshi, you pull your opponent forward with your arm around his waist, then throw on your waist. Move in with your hip low. Make your throw only after your opponent's hip is sufficiently close. With your left hand, pull your opponent out off balance, forward to your left. Bring his waist sufficiently close to place him on your hips. Then, with both elbows outstretched, pull him straight up to throw. With your left hand under your opponent's side, as you come to grapple, pull his waist close and perform ogoshi. Here the opponent's hanegoshi is turned into ogoshi. Pull your opponent's waist close as he attacks with a hanegoshi. Step up close with both your feet and throw using the ogoshi technique. This is not utsurigoshi. Ukigoshi. In ukigoshi, you draw your opponent's waist in close using one of your arms, then throw using the twisting motion of your waist. In the practice form, the throw is made as your opponent attacks, as if to strike. In ukigoshi, you throw in a twisting motion after bending back fully, using your left hip as the fulcrum. Your shoulder is placed deep under your opponent's arm, and your arm secures his waist position parallel to his belt. Look once again at how you bend your back, how your shoulder should be positioned, and how your waist is twisted. Let's see the difference between an ogoshi and ukigoshi. In ogoshi, keep your knees bent and your waist low. Then straighten the knees and make the throw with an upward pulling movement. In ukigoshi, your waist is only lowered shallowly and your lower left hip is made the fulcrum as you twist and throw. This is a rare film showing Professor Kano explaining his favourite technique, ukigoshi, before the practice hall of Tokyo Higher Normal School in the early part of the century. Tsurigoshi. In tsurigoshi, you grasp your opponent's belt from behind, then bringing him in close, lift and throw on your hip. You must defend against your opponent's tsurikomigoshi while you grasp his belt from under his arm as you throw. In this form of tsurigoshi, you grasp your opponent's belt over his shoulder. Pulling your opponent forward, you grasp his belt over his shoulder and throw using tsurigoshi. Throwing as you grasp the front part of your opponent's belt is also an application of the tsurigoshi technique. It's called a tsurigoshi only when the belt is grasped in making the throw. Suri Komigoshi. This is the kata form of Suri Komigoshi. The moment your opponent protects himself by bending backwards, lower your hips and, making them the fulcrum of your throw, pull him down with both your arms. In randori, you pull your opponent up with both arms and throw him on your hips when moving either forwards or backwards. Take firm hold of the rear of your opponent's jacket when he's bent forward in a defensive posture to throw, pulling him up. This is also Suri Komigoshi. There is an application of Suri Komigoshi which is generally called Sode Suri Komigoshi. By pulling up your opponent's arm, you destroy his balance. You then have a choice of either taking hold of his sleeve opening like this, or taking hold of the elbow section of his sleeve. When grasping the sleeve opening, you sometimes do so by pushing your opponent's hand away. The throw is made when he comes back with the same hand to grasp your jacket. Here's a powerful Suri Komigoshi executed by Khabareli of the Soviet Union at the Kano Cup tournament. The Lausanne World Judo Championship Lightweight Division Finals. Nobuyuki Sato wins with a Sode Suri Komigoshi. Suri Komigoshi shown by Nobutoshi Hikage at the All Japan Judo Championship Tournament. Koshi Guruma. In Koshi Guruma, you grasp your opponent by the neck and throw in a twisting motion with him on your hips. Control your opponent by holding his neck. Place your waist deep under him and push to the side. Koshi Guruma must be executed by holding your opponent's neck. Harai Goshi. In Harai Goshi, you pull your opponent close and throw with your hip and legs in a sweeping motion. The nage no kata form is created by pulling your opponent close by putting a hand under his arm and raising him to destroy his balance. In randori, you seldom put your hand in as shown here. Here the technique is performed by following the motion of your opponent who withdraws. Another chance for using Harai Goshi presents itself when you pull your opponent out sideways, as shown here. The body movement when executing Harai Goshi varies, as when you crisscross and change the position of your feet. For a moment, your opponent mistakes it for a right-hander technique. Then you turn and go into the motion for Harai Goshi. Let's take a look at various forms of haraigoshi from tournament films. This is haraigoshi as performed by Castro of the United States. An All-Japan Judo Championship, haraigoshi, performed by Nobutoshi Hikage. The throw is made in a winding motion the moment his opponent comes up close and tries to defend himself by swinging his right foot over. Haraigoshi by Yoshimi Masaki at an All Japan Judo Championship. Hanegoshi. Hanegoshi is a technique of throwing your opponent by bouncing him up using the movement of your hip and foot. Hanegoshi executed in pursuit. It's made the moment your opponent retreats and brings his left foot down. The leg to be used in bouncing your opponent up should be bent a little. You bounce him up around the lower part of his knee. The technique may be used after guiding your opponent sideways. This is hanegoshi, where you jump in to execute the technique. Pull your opponent downwards, and when he straightens himself up in reaction, jump in to execute this technique. Let's look at the difference between hanegoshi and haraigoshi. In hanegoshi, you bounce your opponent up with your leg bent. In haraigoshi, your leg is straight as you bounce your opponent up. Uchimata looks similar to hanegoshi, except you place your leg in between your opponent's legs and bounce him up. Utsurigoshi. Utsurigoshi is a kind of technique used when your opponent attacks with koshiwaza, to raise him up and throw him on your hips. This is an utsurigoshi technique which originates from the opponent's hanegoshi. This is utsurigoshi, which started out as an uchimata by the opponent. You completely raise your opponent up by the waist and opening outwards, throw after moving him over on your hips. It can also be executed after your opponent attacks with an osotogari. In this case, you draw your foot a moment before he executes his osotogari. The second World Cup tournament. Vesniak of the Soviet Union wins with Utsuri Goshi. Ushiro Goshi. This is the throw to use when your opponent attacks with Koshiwaza. You lift your opponent up and throw him down in front of you. This Ushiro Goshi has developed from the opponent's Hane Goshi. Ushiro Goshi executed just as your opponent tries to defend himself by curling his feet around yours. When changing into Ushiro Goshi, your opponent may try defending himself by attacking your foot, as in Ouchigari. You then lift up the foot that's been attacked, hoist him up, then throw him down. This is in case your opponent defends himself using something like Kouchigari. If your opponent defends himself by using Kouchigari from inside, lift your foot that's been attacked, hoist him up, and throw him down. When your opponent attacks with Osotogari, push his waist up with your leg as you throw him down. Ushiro Goshi resulting from your opponent's Hane Goshi. You can also execute the technique like this without holding your opponent's hip, but simply lifting it up by using your left foot. These different follow-on techniques are all called Ushiro Goshi. Dakiage. When on the floor, you grasp your opponent's belt to make him bend over. Then, with your arms crossed, grip both lapels to bring him near. Then, standing up on both legs, raise him up at once deftly to the shoulder level. This technique is dangerous if your opponent is dropped after being raised up, so that the effect of the throw was recognized only in 1926. In those days, an Ippon was declared when you succeeded in raising your opponent up to the shoulder high level at one go. But today, the match is suspended with a call of mate. The effect of the technique is not recognized. Hizaguruma. Hizaguruma is a technique of supporting your opponent's knee with your foot as you throw. As your opponent tries to step forward, place the sole of your foot on his knee. Your opponent will turn and fall in a twisting motion. Hizaguruma performed after transferring your right hand from his left lapel to mid-sleeve. Another method, where your opponent's knee is bent. Step forward. Execute the technique as if trying to bend your opponent's knee. He then falls in a twisting motion. Hizaguruma following on from your opponent's Kouchigari. Raise your attacked foot and follow on with a Hizaguruma. This is not Kouchigaishi, however. Sasae Tsurikomiashi. Sasae Tsurikomiashi is executed by putting the sole of your foot on your opponent's ankle and throwing with that as the fulcrum. This is when your opponent has stepped forward. This is when you first lightly slap the inside of your opponent's left foot before executing the technique. The aim of this is to destroy your opponent's balance toward the tip of his right foot as you slap his foot from inside. Sasae Tsuriko Miyashi, made to look like O Sotogari. When O Sotogari is executed, your opponent defends by moving his weight forward in reaction. Turn your body at that moment, support with your foot as you throw. Sasae Tsuriko Miyashi, executed by Anton Heysink of the Netherlands, the victor of the Tokyo Olympics. Another Sasae Tsuriko Miyashi, as performed by Chonosuke Takagi, the winner of the World Championships in Lausanne. All Japan champion Naoya Ogawa performs Sasae Tsuriko Miyashi. Ogawa grapples his opponent from his left side, brings him in tight using both hands in a characteristically powerful twisting motion. Harai Tsuriko Miyashi. In Harai Tsuriko Miyashi, you can throw your opponent by a sweeping blow to the rear of his foot. Here, the right foot of the opponent is swept away as he tries to retreat, and then he's thrown. You slap at the inside of the foot of your opponent as he tries to retreat to destroy his balance towards the tip of his right foot, then sweep him off his feet. Let's compare these two techniques. In Sasae Tsuriko Miyashi, you support your opponent's foot as you throw. In Harai Tsuriko Miyashi, you slap at your opponent's feet as you make your throw. Sasae and Harai are similar in form, but are different in that one has the Sasaeru, or supporting motion, whereas the other has the Harai Ageru, or sweeping motion. Deashi Harai. In Deashi Harai, you sweep away one of your opponent's feet that's moved forward. When your opponent steps forward with his right foot, you open up with your right and sweep using your left foot. Here you sweep the retreating right foot of the opponent who's trying to move back. Here you lead your opponent around and sweep his right foot as he steps forward. This is following on from Hizaguruma. When you try Hizaguruma, your opponent reciprocates, stepping forward with his right foot. You then sweep away that right foot. In another instance, you release your opponent's hand as he pulls, and using your own hand, bring his foot forward, which you can then sweep away. At the Seoul World Championships, Masaki triumphs over Rashwan with an ippon using Deashi Harai. A an All Japan Judo Championship. Look at the marvelously well-timed Daiashi Harai performed by Masaki. At the Kano Cup tournament, Hiromitsu Takano executes a Daiashi Harai. Okuriyashi Harai. Okuriyashi Harai is a technique where you sweep away both of your opponent's feet as you throw him. You lead your opponent around and sweep away both his feet. In Okuriyashi Harai, you sweep away both your opponent's feet as they're together. Okuriyashi Harai performed in two steps. You step in and sweep away the retreating foot of your opponent. Let's compare similar techniques. In Okuriyashi Harai, you sweep away both your opponent's feet together. In Daiashi Harai, you sweep away your opponent's foot as he steps forward. In Harai Tsurikomiyashi, you sweep away your opponent's foot as it retreats towards the far corner. We decide the technique used according to these criteria. Tsubame Gaeshi. Tsubame Gaeshi is a technique of throwing your opponent by reversing his foot sweep into your own. Shift directly to your right or left. If your opponent attacks with Daiashi Harai or Okuriyashi Harai, you dodge it and turn it into Tsubame Gaeshi. Even when moving back, you can also do likewise. Kosoto Gari. Changing your opponent's Taiotoshi into Kosoto Gari. Dodging your opponent's Taiotoshi, make him off balance, standing on both his heels, then cut him down in the direction of his toes using the back of your feet. Your foot will be placed on roughly the same line as your opponent's. When you're clipping, you should do so from your opponent's heels, in the direction of his toes, as if rubbing the surface of the mat. Your opponent should fall suddenly on the spot. Kosoto Gari, performed by Shozo Fuji, a former middleweight class world champion. He catches his opponent with Kosoto Gari just as he comes back from applying a right side Osoto Gari. Kosoto Gake. Kosoto Gake is a technique of throwing your opponent in a kind of pulling up motion. Sometimes the sole of the foot, at other times the leg is used for clipping. As the opponent withdraws his left foot, shifting his weight onto his other foot, you make him fall, hooking with your leg. You first try an uchimata, then the moment your opponent tries to defend himself, leaning backward, you turn it into kosoto gake. Here you take hold of the rear collar to bring your opponent in close, push him back to go off balance, then hook and make him fall. Now let's see the differences between similar techniques. In Kosotogari, you step in close to the side of your opponent, make him lose balance on his heel and clip him down. In Daiashi Harai, the moment your opponent's foot is about to touch the mat, or when his foot is about to be lifted off the mat, you sweep his foot away to make him fall. In Kosotogake, you make your opponent lose his balance by making him stand on his heels as you face him directly. Clip as if to pull your opponent up and backwards as you throw him. World champion Naoya Ogawa shows off Kosotogake, which is his favorite technique. This is a two-stage Kosotogake, performed by Yoshimi Masaki. Marshall of the USA executes Kosotogake, having secured the rear collar and pulled his opponent in close. Or Sotogari. Pull the right leg of your opponent out, then clip him down the moment it touches the mat. Pull his left leg out and cut down on his right leg. Or Sotogari from a Harai Tsurikomiyashi. As your opponent advances to defend himself, cut down on his right leg. Another method is to put your arm under your opponent's and holding his waist from the rear to cut him down. Another is to pull your opponent up by the front of his belt and execute a clip upwards. Here you push your opponent's elbow to make him lose balance and cut him down to the rear. An All-Japan Judo Championship. Yasuhiro Yamashita executes a convincing Or Sotogari. Again, at an All-Japan Judo Championship, Or Sotogari, following on from a Harai Goshi, performed by Hiromi Masaki. The 1987 World Judo Championships. Hirotaka Okada performs a magnificent Or Sotogari. Or Soto Otoshi. Or Soto Otoshi is made by pushing down your opponent by sliding your leg down his rear waist. In Or Soto Otoshi, your opponent's foot must be on the matting as you make the sliding clip. Here you see Or Soto Otoshi made with the opponent's neck on your arm. Let's look at the differences between Or Sotogari and Or Soto Otoshi. If your opponent's foot goes up in the air, it's Or Sotogari. If your opponent's leg remains on the matting as you sweep and he goes down, it's an osoto otoshi. At the World Judo Championships, Hitoshi Saito makes osoto otoshi. Osoto guruma. In osoto guruma, you begin your throw as in osoto gari, but cut both your opponent's legs as you twist him down. Sometimes it's done in two movements. In a variation of this, you step behind both your opponent's legs with your right leg and make him fall, as in Taiotoshi. Osoto Gaeshi. As your opponent steps in trying to execute osoto gari, you instead cut him down at that moment using the same throw. Here, the opponent's osoto gari is returned after a short delay. As you defend yourself against your opponent's osoto gari by pulling back your right foot, you counter with an osoto gari. As you defend yourself against your opponent's osoto gari by pulling back your left foot, you counter with a twist. As you defend against your opponent's osoto gari by pulling back your left foot, you counter as if in osoto gaeshi. Another example where an opportunity to counter came still later. Oguruma. Oguruma is a technique where you make your throw by turning your opponent around your leg as an axis. Placing your leg near the lower abdomen of your opponent to use as an axis, you turn him around and throw. Execute Hizaguruma, and the moment your opponent counters with his right foot, follow on with a Oguruma. Oguruma was one of the favorite techniques of the 10th Dan, Kyuzo Mifune. He's captured the moment his opponent tries to step forward on his right foot. Ashiguruma. In Ashiguruma, you place your foot on your opponent's knee and throw with that as an axis. It's the same principle as Hizaguruma. Here, an osoto gari is followed by ashiguruma. First, you execute osoto gari. When your opponent responds by withdrawing his left foot, you follow with ashiguruma. Let's see the difference between osoto gari and ashiguruma. When you use osotogari, your opponent falls directly to the rear. With ashiguruma, your opponent twists and falls forward. The name of the technique is decided by looking closely at these points. Yamashita wins with ashiguruma at the 1955 All Japan Judo Championships. Uchimata. In using the uchimata technique, you first pull your opponent forward. Then just when his weight shifts to his left foot as he moves forward, you throw by sweeping up from between his legs. Here you jump in to make your throw the moment your opponent withdraws his foot and touches the mat. Pull your opponent forward to make him assume jigotai, or a self-defense position. Then jump in and apply uchimata just as he raises himself. This is a method generally known as ken-ken uchimata. You sweep with your left leg to destroy your opponent's balance and throw. And uchimata after having switched feet. The movement is similar to that of harai goshi and oguruma. The method used is to pull your opponent sideways, then sweep up on the leg he steps out on. First, you make a move, as in performing ouchigari. Then it's transformed into uchimata. In this situation, the objective is to cause your opponent to open up his legs and lean forward off balance. If your opponent defends himself by going down on one knee, he's still judged to be standing, and the uchimata is recognized. Uchimata, performed by Seiki Nosei of Japan. Pesniak of the USSR follows an opponent in to perform an uchimata. Uchimata performed by Olympic champion Yamashita. Another Olympic champion, Hitoshi Saito, performs a variation uchimata. When his opponent counters by taking hold of Saito's knee with his right hand, Saito, turning left, transforms the movement into an uchimata. An uchimata by Sumio Endo, where he makes use of the twisting of his body. Uchimata gaishi. In uchimata gaishi, when your opponent attacks with uchimata, you counter by cutting back on his pivotal foot. The tip drill made 大内刈り。Pull your opponent's foot forward. Then just as he tries to put his weight on that foot, clip his foot and make him fall. Here, the opponent's foot is being clipped as he tries to retreat. Here, the opponent is pulled out sideways, then his foot is clipped as if to open it further out. Here, the opponent is pulled in close, then clipped the moment he tries to rise up. Here, when the opponent tries to get away by raising his foot, he's pushed forward and cut down off balance. Here, his leg is grabbed as you clip. In the World Championships, Vachon of France performs an Ouchigari. Ouchigari performed by Yamashita. At the finals of the second Kano Cup tournament, Katsuhiko Kashiwazaki performs an Ouchigari, taking hold of his opponent's foot. Ouchigaeshi. Ouchigaeshi is a technique of countering your opponent's Ouchigari with an Ouchigari of your own. There are two ways of countering. One is to clip the foot that's clipping you, and the other is to clip your opponent's pivotal foot. Here, the opponent's foot is clipped back as he tries to clip you. Here, you counter by clipping both your opponent's attacking foot as well as his pivotal foot at the same time. Dodge your opponent's Ouchigari and counter with a twisting motion. This is also Ouchigaeshi. Use your opponent's force to return the attack by twisting to the right. First dodging your opponent's Ouchigari, then throwing and twisting to your left. Isao Matsui performs an Ouchigari. Preschel of West Germany performs an Ouchigaeshi as they rise from the Newaza position. Ouchigari. In Ouchigari, You pull your opponent's foot forward, then you clip just as his foot comes down on the mat. In this instance, you cut down on the retreating foot of your opponent. Here, Kochigari is performed by pulling the opponent off sideways, and here you cause your opponent to open his feet wide and clip after subduing his defense. Another method is to clip holding one of your opponent's feet. You may sometimes turn around once as you take hold of your opponent's foot and make him fall. Bergmans of Belgium performs Kochigari from an uchimata position. Hitoshi Saito at the 1988 All Japan Weight Class Championships. He performs Kochigari, taking hold of his opponent's leg. Hane Goshi Gaeshi. There are two ways of performing Hane Goshi Gaeshi. One is a leg technique whereby you reap the pivotal foot of your opponent, and another is a hip technique of pushing up with the hip and twisting before countering. At times you hold the opponent's waist and reap your opponent's pivotal foot. With your hip, you bounce your opponent up in a large motion, then throw, twisting with both hands. When bouncing your opponent with your hip, you may at times simultaneously sweep upwards using your leg. Harai Goshi Gaeshi. In Harai Goshi Gaeshi, you counter by reaping your opponent's pivotal foot for executing Harai Goshi. Just as your opponent attacks with Harai Goshi, you counter by extending your hips, then reap his pivotal foot to make him fall. The technique you use in countering, holding your opponent's hips, is also Harai Goshi Gaeshi. Here the opponent's hips are being held, but as the counter action is reaping his pivotal foot, it's not Ushiro Goshi. Ushiro Goshi is a technique where you raise your opponent up, holding him by the hip and letting him fall. Tomoe Nage. In Tomoe Nage, you drop backwards while putting a foot on your opponent's lower abdomen and throw him back over your head. Here, the technique is applied just as soon as your opponent steps forward and tries to put his weight on his foot. Here, the opponent is pulled out forward at a slight angle as the technique is applied. This is the way you apply the technique when your opponent is in a right-handed position, making him go off balance on his toes and making him fall to his right as you throw. Here, the throw is made over your head when your opponent is in the right-handed position. Here, the opponent is thrown by pushing him up using both feet. At the Seoul World Championships, Shinji Hosokawa clinches victory with a tomoe nage. Yusuke Yamamoto at the third Kano Cup tournament. A tomoe nage throwing to the right. At the Moscow World Championship, Kenichi Haraguchi executes a tomoe nage, turning himself over as well. Uranage. The principle behind this form is to use the force of your opponent as you dodge his striking motion and to throw him, lifting him up on your hip as you sacrifice yourself by falling backward. Here, the opponent's hanegoshi is transformed into an uranage. As the opponent attacks with a hanegoshi, hold his hips and bring him close and throw him directly behind over your shoulder. Another way is to hold and raise your opponent up from the front, then leaning back, throw by sacrificing yourself. An All-Japan Judo Championship. Here, Sumio Endo performs uranage, which is a transformation of his opponent's kouchigari. Sumigaeshi. You start with both sides grappling in a defensive position. The technique was already in existence in Koryu, one of the older schools of Jiu-Jitsu, and the exact same form has been handed down. In the present-day Dandori, we do not start directly from such a position. In Sumigaeshi, you fall backwards in a self-sacrificing movement. Place the instep of your right foot in the crook of his left knee and lift him up over your head. You pull your opponent forward, grasping his rear collar to execute sumigaeshi. Here it's done by grasping your opponent's rear collar or his back and starts with uchimata. Here it's a quick turn around from the uchimata position, followed on with sumigaeshi. Sumigaeshi is one of the favorite techniques of Verichev of the Soviet Union. Hikkomigaeshi. Hikkomigaeshi is another Koryu technique. First, grapple in the defensive posture, holding your opponent's right arm with both arms. Fall down and place your right foot on your opponent's right inner thigh. Then throw over your right shoulder. This was the original Hikkomigaeshi. In a dandari situation, the throw is often made by pulling your opponent in close, holding his belt at the rear, then by throwing him, falling down in a self-sacrificing motion. The place where your foot is applied varies. There's no set place. This is the method of throwing by falling to your side. In this case, it becomes yokostemiwaza. You pull your opponent's belt at the rear close and throw by falling sideways in a self-sacrificing motion. Let's see the differences between this and a sumigaeshi, which look very much alike. In sumigaeshi, you throw by grasping the rear collar of your opponent. In hikkomigaeshi, you throw by grasping the rear part of your opponent's belt. The difference between the two may be judged by whether you hold your opponent's belt or not. Hikkomigaeshi is one of the favorite techniques of Katsuhiko Kashiwazaki. He used it in the 1981 World Championships. Tawara Gaeshi. In Tawara Gaeshi, you hold your opponent from above to pull him close, then throw as you fall face up in a self-sacrificing motion. In this situation, your opponent defends himself by leaning forward. This Tawara Gaeshi follows upon the opponent's Morote Gari. When your opponent jumps in close to execute Morote Gari, you pull your feet back, drop your hip low to defend yourself, then counter. Ukiwaza. In ukiwaza, you step sideways on one foot, sacrificing your balance, and throw your opponent in the direction of your foot. Around 1883, when the nage no kata form of the throw was established, the technique was performed starting with grappling in the self-defense posture. This is ukiwaza, performed by pulling the opponent forward. This ukiwaza is performed by stepping in with your right foot when your opponent withdraws his left foot. At times, you might assume an oblique defensive posture after pulling your opponent forward by grasping his rear collar and a sleeve and throw from a self-sacrificing posture. This is a technique of following on from kataguruma to ukiwaza. In this technique, as you're sacrificing yourself in making the throw, it is not kataguruma. The opponent is pulled by rolling up his right arm under your left arm, then thrown, twisting your body to the left. Yoko Otoshi. In Yoko Otoshi, you step to one side and throw your opponent directly to one side in a sacrificing motion. Observe the off-balancing to the side and sacrificing motion. Pull your opponent to one side, make him go off balance, then throw, sacrificing yourself, as you can see, in a yoko otoshi, off balancing and throwing are done to the side. Tani otoshi. In tani otoshi, you step behind both legs of your opponent in a sacrificing motion, then throw him down directly behind. If you can push his elbow up, it becomes even more easy to make him go off balance and fall backwards. Here, Kuchiki Daoshi is transformed into Tani Otoshi. On occasions when Kuchiki Daoshi cannot be executed, you might step in, throwing in a self-sacrificing motion. This also is a kind of Tani Otoshi. Here you hold your opponent's right arm under your left arm. You perform Tani Otoshi, sacrificing yourself. Take a look at a different kind of Tani Otoshi. Step in behind both your opponent's legs, leaning to force him to fall. Let's look at these three similar techniques. In ukiwaza, you make your opponent lose his balance forward. He's thrown in that direction. In yoko otoshi, you make your opponent lose his balance to the side. He's thrown in that direction. In tani otoshi, you make your opponent lose his balance backward, and he's thrown in that direction. Observe Nobutoshi Hikage, a world champion for 1983 and 85, use his favorite technique, Tani Otoshi. Yoko Watare. In Yoko Watare, you step in with both of your feet next to your opponent's feet, then throw him over your body, sacrificing yourself. The moment your opponent's feet are together, sacrifice yourself and throw him above your body. Here, the opponent's ogoshi is transformed into a Yoko Watare. As soon as your opponent attacks with ogoshi, you open sideways and turn it into a yoko wakare. Transforming your opponent's deashi harai. When your opponent attacks with deashi harai, step up close and sacrificing yourself, throw sideways with a yoko wakare. Yoko wakare can also be performed as mastemi waza on the floor. Yoko gake. When practicing the kata, destroy your opponent's balance in about 2.5 steps, then throw, sacrificing yourself. In this technique, it's important to make your opponent go off balance till he's supported only by his toes. You sweep, thrusting powerfully with your sole just underneath your opponent's ankle from the front, then sacrificing yourself, throw him parallel to your body. Because yoko gake is extremely difficult to set up, it's hardly ever used in dandori. You sometimes see it used in conjunction with sasae tsurikomi ashi in practice. The opponent falls after being thrown in a large whirl. This, too, is an application of yokogake. Dakiwakare. In fighting on the mat, if your opponent does not get up, you can raise and hold him up from the side, then twisting, throw over your body. It appears that in the early days of judo, the effect of this technique was allowed even if you were on a mat. However, under the present system of judging, the effect of the throw is no longer recognized. Here, standing fight becomes dakiwakare. When your opponent attacks with an uchimata, you might try catching him from the rear to apply another technique. Then, when he lets down both of his hands and escapes, you can apply dakiwakare. The effect of the technique is recognized in this case. Yokoguruma. If you try throwing your opponent with an uranage as he comes at you, he defends himself by twisting. Put your right foot between both his feet at that moment and throw, sacrificing yourself. Here, the opponent's hanegoshi is turned into this technique. Here's the way to apply it, following on from taneotoshi. The moment your opponent bends forward to defend himself against taneotoshi, then you follow with this. Soto makikomi. In soto makikomi, hold your opponent's arm under your arm. Step in close with your hips, then turning, throw him over your body in a wrapping motion. Place your hip close to the opponent to use as an axis in the throw. This is the basic principle of soto makikomi. Placing your hip next to your opponent, but not so deep, and throwing him. This is also soto makikomi. Here's soto makikomi, where you first step in with your feet. You can also step sideways in a large motion outside your opponent's right foot to wrap him around. When applying hanegoshi or haraigoshi, your opponent may defend himself by holding close to you. It may be possible to throw him using the wrapping technique. Uchi makikomi. Uchi makikomi is similar to ippon seoi nage. Grasp your opponent by the arm and twist sideways to wrap him around you. Use your hip as an axis, twist and throw in a wrapping motion. This is the basis of uchi makikomi. Here's Uchimaki Tomi, where you step out on your right foot to set it up. Here's Uchimaki Komi after you've made your opponent retreat. Here you follow on from Ippon Seoi Nage. The moment your opponent defends himself by turning away, you grasp his neck with an arm and pull, wrapping him around you. We distinguish between Seoi Nage and Uchimaki Komi by whether you carried your opponent on your shoulder or simply wrapped him around you as you controlled his arm. Hanemaki Komi. In Hanemaki Komi, you throw in a wrapping motion as you lift your opponent up with Hanegoshi. There are two methods of executing this throw. The first is to lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm. The second method is to lift your opponent up with Hanegoshi, then wrap him around you. There's a difference in the timing of when you take hold of your opponent's arm. In this case, the opponent's collar has simply been grasped and he's not been wrapped around. This is Hanegoshi, not Hanemaki Komi. Harai Maki Komi. In Harai Maki Komi, you lift your opponent up using Harai Goshi, then throw, wrapping him around you. There are two ways to throw. In the first method, lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm like this. Another method is to lift your opponent up with Harai Goshi, then place his arm under yours to wrap him around you. There's a difference in the timing of when you grasp your opponent's arm. Again, in this case, the opponent's collar has simply been grasped and he's not been wrapped around. This is Harai Goshi, not Harai Maki Komi. Watch this breathtaking Harai Maki Komi as executed by Sumio Endo at the World Championships in Paris. Uchimata Maki Komi. In Uchimata Maki Komi, you lift your opponent up using Uchimata, then throw, wrapping him around you. There are two ways to make the throw. The first is to lift up your opponent and wrap him around you as you grasp him by the arm. The second method is to lift your opponent up with Uchimata, then wrap him around you and throw. Please observe carefully the timing of grasping the opponent's arm under yours. Sumio Endo performs Uchimata Maki Komi at the All Japan Judo Championships. Osoto Maki Komi. Osoto Makikomi starts with one of the Osoto Gari family of techniques, followed by either an outer or inner wraparound throw. In the first case, following your opponent's defense of an Osoto Gari, you throw by wrapping him around you in an outward direction. From an Osoto Gari, you lean on your opponent and throw him, wrapping him outwards. The final technique used is Soto Makikomi, but as it follows Osoto Gari, the throw is called Osoto Makikomi. In the second case, you start out with Osoto Gari, where you place your right arm underneath your opponent's right arm. As he defends himself, you counter by throwing forward, by wrapping him around yours, as in Uchi Makikomi. The final technique appears to be Uchi Makikomi, but as it follows on Osoto Gari, it is called Osoto Makikomi. Observe Osoto Makikomi by an Olympic champion, Zeissenbacher. Kani Basami. Kani Basami is a technique of throwing where you sandwich your opponent's body using both your feet. As soon as your feet are on a line with your opponent's, sandwich his abdomen and legs between your legs and throw in a sacrificing movement. See how Oguruma is followed by Kani Basami. As you attack with Oguruma, your opponent tries to grasp your ankle to trip you. At that moment, follow with Kani Basami. At an All Japan Championship, Hirotoshi Watanabe attempts Kani Basami on Yamashita. Kawazu Gake. Kawazu Gake is considered dangerous as you fall together with your opponent. It's prohibited in a tournament. In Kawazu Gake, you pull your opponent's neck close and hook one of his feet from inside. As you lean back, you throw both yourself and your opponent at the same time. Quite often, it's very difficult to judge the name of the technique as it's applied. Also, with more research and development, new techniques may well be born. However, the name will be chosen from one of the 65 throws, depending on the principle behind the technique used. We hope this video will help you to understand the classifications and names of the techniques, their variations, as well as the principles behind the form and the execution of the throws.